So today we're talking about piriformis syndrome versus sciatica. These two have a lot of overlap, and I get this a lot when patients approach me with like gluteal pain or hip pain, and they think it's piriformis syndrome, but it may actually be sciatica, and the other way around too. The other question we're trying to answer is it coming from the back or is it coming from the hip? And so I'm gonna help you through that today. I'm gonna help you go over a simple test that you could do to help figure out, okay, is this coming from my back, sciatica, or is this coming from my hip? What you can do for treatment-wise, and some common similarities and differences between the two. So hang with me, we're gonna have some fun. You're gonna walk away with this, with that information, so you can help figure out the best next step for you. So we're talking about sciatica versus piriformis syndrome. Now, to start, let's be clear, they're both an issue with the sciatic nerve, and that sciatic nerve starts in your lower back, goes through your glute and goes down your leg. This is your glute muscles. You have multiple that attach here, and here's your leg. And so when you have an issue with the sciatic nerve, you will have nerve pain down the leg, whether that be sharp burning discomfort or even weakness into the leg, but those are typical nerve symptoms. So both of these have nerve involvement. Now, the biggest difference between these two is that nerve involvement's either in your butt or it's in your lower back, but they both can be a pain in the butt for sure. And so we're gonna start with sciatica. It comes from the lower back and goes down and through the glute and goes down the leg. Sciatica is typically caused from a disc involvement or something that's pinching the nerve or just occupying space around the nerve to give you symptoms. And so starts in the back and goes down the leg. You're talking disc herniations or some sort of stenosis. Whereas piriformis syndrome, the issue is happening into the glute. There's no issue with the lower back. So that is why it's much more common for you to have sciatica versus piriformis syndrome, and that most people are having an issue with their back versus their glute because of the causes are more common to have back issues than you are buttock issues due to muscle. And so piriformis syndrome is typically caused from microtrauma or macrotrauma, which microtrauma would be you're working out a ton, you're sitting a lot, or you're like a truck driver, you have a wallet in your back pocket, and you're having this repetitive trauma to the piriformis muscle, which is irritating that sciatic nerve, which is causing pain down the leg. Other causes of piriformis syndrome are macrotrauma, which be you fell on your butt. You had a really bad fall onto your glute muscle, which irritated the nerve, which caused pain down the leg, or you've had a hip replacement or some sort of surgery in the area that would cause scar tissue around the piriformis muscle. Again, that's not as common as back issues, so that's why it's a little bit more rare to have piriformis syndrome. Now, the other causes of piriformis syndrome could just be anatomical variation. What that means is that you're genetically built a certain way, and that piriformis muscle in which that sciatic nerve courses right over is just different than someone else's. About 10% of people have differences in their piriformis muscle. So again, that's not as common as sciatica or other back issues. And so whether it be microtrauma, macrotrauma, or anatomical variations, those can be your causes of piriformis syndrome. Now, the way we treat those things are very different because with sciatica, we're treating the back and the nerve at the same time, whereas piriformis syndrome, we're really just narrowing down on the hips and glutes to work at the integrity and the environment of the sciatic nerve and the piriformis muscle. So you're gonna be with sciatica, you're gonna be doing a lot of nerve glides and back mobility work, depending on the like where you are in the healing process, and then piriformis syndrome, you're gonna be working more in the hips. Now, to figure out which one you may have, it's a little bit different. And so in a clinical exam, when I work with somebody or you work with somebody as a movement specialist, like your primary care, chiro, or PT, when they are trying to figure out the differences, some key differences that we see is that sciatica will cause some weakness into the leg, where piriformis syndrome won't. It doesn't interrupt the nerve signal that intensely to cause weakness into the leg. And so that's a big difference that we look at as well. And there's some other things, but we're combining the movement of your back and hips to help figure out the differences. Now, what you can do, and what I'm gonna show you in just a second, is a simple test at home to figure out, okay, is this more sciatica or piriformis syndrome? Because sometimes going into the exam, telling the provider that you have piriformis syndrome and you don't actually have piriformis syndrome can just lead things down the wrong path. So let's figure that out. In just 30 seconds, we're gonna go over that. But those are some big differences, similarities, and causes between sciatica and piriformis syndrome. Okay, so let's go over a simple test that you can be doing on your own to figure out piriformis syndrome or sciatica. So this is one that I actually do with my patients, and so I'll have you lay down. You're gonna be feet flat. You're going to have your knees bent and just be comfortable, okay? So in this position, if you have either of those, you really shouldn't have much discomfort at this time. depending on the severity, of course. And so in this position, what I'm gonna have you do is you're gonna do a pelvic tilt backwards. And so I'm in a neutral position. I'm going to contract my abs and try to flatten my lower back to the table. And what that's doing is it's rounding out my lower back into a flexion moment. And if you have sciatica, it typically doesn't like flexion. And so what I'll do is I'll have my patients roll into this flexion moment, hold it, and they go, oh, I could feel my glute and my pain down my leg. I'm like, okay, now relax from that position and just kind of poke your butt into the table and increase this space. Did that pain get better? And they're like, yes, that absolutely changed my discomfort. So we're talking about having symptoms and pain when you tilt back and flex, and having relief when you extend. That's a classic presentation of sciatica. If I had piriformis syndrome, I would have no difference in those two movements. If I moved my back, I would have no difference in my glute or leg pain. And that would tell me, okay, maybe it's more piriformis syndrome. And so both of those movements can help give you an idea if it's coming from your hip or your lower back, which completely dictates the treatment. And so if more sciatica, you're gonna be working on back and hip mobility, which I have past videos on as well as working on your gliding your sciatic nerve, the big nerve, and help improving the neural mobility of that because of its involvement. Piriformis syndrome, you're gonna be doing a little bit of strengthening, stretching, it's a little bit more straightforward. But the treatment techniques are just different for both of us. Like having an idea of treating on your own or before you go to your doctor's appointment can just give you that leg up in the treatment. So if you guys found any value in this video, please like or subscribe. Please leave a comment if you have any questions. I just wanna put out information that you find useful. But as always, guys, stay healthy, keep moving, and take care of yourself.